again with a few more reminders on that autumn statement. The reminder this time is around just what is frozen. It's a bit like looking inside your freezer and going, what have we got in here? So let's just remind ourselves, what is frozen? So here we go. Of course, perhaps the one that's most memorable are the personal allowance, is the personal allowance and the tax band. They have been frozen beyond their previous four-year frozen period to a further 2 years. So they'll be frozen until April, the 5th of April, 2028. So that is your personal allowance and the higher rate threshold, both frozen. Then we thought the additional rate threshold's bound to be frozen as well, isn't it? Well, it is, but at a lower level. So it's been moved down, of course, from 150,000, which is where it was before, above which you pay 45%, 46% in Scotland, where it's called the top rate. So it's been moved down to that rather strange figure of 125,140 pounds to avoid a crazy little 67.5% marginal band on the £140 that goes over 125,000. Otherwise, you'd think, why didn't you just make it £125,000? It's 125,140, which effectively means that the 40% tax band ends, your 40% tax paying status ends at £100,000, because after that, your personal allowance starts to be cut back by that £1 for every £2 that it exceeds £100,000, which gets us to 125,140, because the 25,140 is double the personal allowance. So there we are. That's where, that's the sort of freezing of that new additional rate threshold, but at its reduced level. Then, of course, let's not forget, sometimes we do, but let's not forget that the national insurance thresholds and limits will be the main ones. That is class one primary threshold, class two lower profits limit, class four lower and upper profits limit, the upper earnings limit for employees, secondary threshold, all that stuff, all those thresholds and limits will be frozen until the 5th of April 2028. And then we have, of course, the inheritance tax nil rate bands, the nil rate band, and the residence nil rate band also being frozen. Really powerful freezes, these are. These are deep freezes because they are going to generate a fair bit of money to HMRC in a way that most people know now, that it's not so much stealth, it's stealth in plain sight because everyone knows about it, but it still doesn't feel quite so bad in that it isn't a tax increase. It is effectively an increase in the amount of tax that will be taken, but it doesn't feel like a tax increase. That's why they work so well for the government. It will generate and be a major contributor to that generation of an extra £25 billion a year from 25-26. And then on from that, of course. So all of those frozen thresholds, what allowances, rates, what do they mean? They mean that there will be more taxpayers. It means there will be more higher rate taxpayers. It's predicted that the current level number of higher rate taxpayers, 5.5 million, will rise to 7.8 million taxpayers, higher rate taxpayers by 27-28. And also there'll be an increase, quite obviously, in the additional rate taxpayers. So what it's going to mean, I think, is that there will be more people who are more likely to be more interested in tax saving, the sort of tax saving that good financial planning can deliver. So on the one hand, of course, that is bad news, but as a financial planner, that is good news because your market has grown.